questions, question orale, the Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Aujourd'hui, on apprend que...
Thank you. Today, we learned that the percentage of Canadians with their own home is at the lowest level in 20 years. That's after seeing house prices double ever since this prime minister came to power. At that time, the average family could pay for their monthly housing costs with 32% of their paycheck, and now that's 50%. And the government is going to make that worse by hiking taxes on paychecks, heating, gas, and groceries. Will the government cancel these tax hikes so Canadians can actually buy or keep their own house? The Honourable Deputy Prime Minister. Mr. Speaker, I'd like to start by congratulating the new leader of the official opposition. This week started with the funeral ceremony for Her Majesty. And it has given us a moment to reflect on the benefits of Westminster-style democracy. A loyal opposition is essential to our political system. It is very clear that we don't agree about many things. The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Honourable Deputy Prime Minister, for her kind words her congratulations. And I look forward to being able to congratulate more young families on the ability to buy their own homes. Unfortunately, it's nice to be in the house, but it would be nice for them to be in a home. But unfortunately, house prices have doubled under this government's policies. In fact, the share of the average Canadian's paycheck needed to pay the average monthly bill on housing has gone from 32% to 50%. The government's solution? To raise paycheck taxes and gas taxes and other taxes. Won't they cancel this tax hike so Canadians can pay their...
Honourable Deputy Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, we've just heard EI premiums mentioned, and so I want you to guess what EI premiums were in 2015. $1.88. And guess who was the minister in charge? The current Conservative leader. Now, guess what EI premiums will be next year? $1.63. That is 25 cents lower. So the leader of the official opposition needs to tell Canadians, was he misguided then, or is he misguided now?
Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Neither, Mr. Speaker. Guess what Canadians paid in 2015 in EI if they earned $60,000 in 2015? $930. Guess what they pay now? $948. That is an increase. Furthermore, if you look at total payroll taxes, they've gone from $3,400 to $4,100 under this government. That's a $700 increase. And the government plans to raise EI premiums. That's the paycheck tax on January 1st, along with other taxes. Why won't they cancel these tax hikes so Canadians can pay their bills?
The Honourable Deputy Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, I would like to remind the Leader of the Official Opposition of something he should have figured out when he was the responsible minister. The CPP and EI contributions every working Canadian makes are how we all pay for our retirement and how we create a safety net for every Canadian in case we lose our jobs. These contributions do not go into general government revenue. At a time of global economic uncertainty, it is the height of irresponsibility for the Conservatives to suggest that we as a country stop putting money away for our retirement.
Here, here. The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
EI premiums do go into general revenues when they go into a surplus, and that is what the government plans to do. They plan to raise both EI and CPP premiums, the paycheck tax, right at a time when it is we are facing 40-year highs in inflation, all-time highs in increased housing prices, 40-year highs in food price inflation, record food bank use. This is the last time that anyone should be raising any tax. Will the government back down from its planned tax hikes on paychecks and on energy?
The Honourable Deputy Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, when it comes to the economy, economy, expectations matter. And that is why it is so irresponsible for these conservatives to talk down the Canadian economy. Yes, things are hard right now, but Canada is better positioned than any country in the world. We have the strongest economic growth and the lowest deficit in the G7. Employment is at historic highs. Inflation is lower in Canada than the U.S., the U.K., and the Eurozone, and it has now come down for 2 months in a row. We'll get through these tough times together.
The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Well, now the Liberals would have Canadians believe that they've never had it so good. Well, I guess if you're jetting around the world singing songs in a beautiful lobby, then that might be true. But if you are the 30-year-old stuck living in your parents' basements because the Liberals have doubled housing prices, you might disagree. If you can't fill up your tank with gas, you might disagree. If you're among the 4 in 5 families that have cut their diets because they can't afford food, you might disagree. And the last thing you would want is a tax hike on your paycheck and on your energy use. Will the Liberals therefore cancel those tax hikes?
The Honourable Deputy Prime Minister.
Canadian struggling today to make ends meet, the last thing you're going to want to do is trust these highly irresponsible conservatives. After all, just this spring, their new leader described crypto as, quote, a way to opt out of inflation. Since then, Bitcoin has crashed by 56%. A Canadian who invested in Bitcoin, according to the reckless advice of this new leader, would have seen her life savings destroyed. That's irresponsible, and Canadians are smart enough to know it.